So that's the assignment. 5,000 steps by hand, or write a computer program that will do it in a minute or two. It's interesting historically that in the years before computers, of course, they didn't have that choice. It was literally 5,000 steps by hand. And the introduction of Euler's method, largely by Katherine Johnson and her group at NASA, changed what scientists were able to do by making these numerical computations possible. The clip from the movie Hidden Figures illustrates that scene very dramatically, with Taraji P. Henson playing Katherine Johnson.
It's when the capsule moves from an elliptical orbit to a parabolic orbit. There's no mathematical formula for that. As we can calculate launch and landing, but without this conversion, the capsule stays in orbit. We can't bring it back home.
Maybe we've been thinking about this all wrong.
How's that?
Maybe it's not new math at all.
It could be old math. Something that looks at the problem numerically and not theoretically. Math is always dependable.
For you, it is.
Euler's method.
Euler's method?
Yes.
That's ancient.
But it works. It works numerically.
That's it.
So that's Hollywood. Let's actually take a second and look at the real Katherine Johnson, who is going to describe the type of calculation she made for the Apollo and the Mercury astronaut missions.
Commander Alan B. Shepard was to become the first man sent into suborbital flight. The Mercury capsule is right on course.
Our office computer for every mission that went out at that time. The height, the speed, and so on. It became a geometry problem.
Ignition sequence start.
I felt most proud of the success of the Apollo mission. They were going to the moon. I computed the path that would get you there. You determined where you were on Earth when you started out, and where the moon would be at a given time. We told them how fast they would be going, and the moon would be there by the time you got there.
Beautiful, just beautiful.
So what Katherine Johnson was doing was solving a differential equation by use of Euler's method. And in this case, the differential equation is, here is the Earth, and here is the moon, and what you want to do is you want to compute a trajectory. Here's your little takeoff point from the Earth, and you want to compute a trajectory that goes like that and lands you exactly on the moon. Then when you come home, you have to have another complicated trajectory calculated. And the Euler's method here is just lots and lots and lots of tiny little finite steps approximating this complicated orbit. And she had been doing that by hand. And then there's a scene which is accurate in the movie where they first wheel in these giant machines, room-size machines, that they call computing machines. And this was a computing machine. Previously, the word computer referred to a person. It was an occupation. What do you do? Oh, I'm a computer for NASA. I work at Langley. And the interesting thing is a very good book, which I recommend, called When Computers Were Human by David Alan Greer. And he tells the whole story of the army of people called computers, and by the way, 98% of them were women, who actually carried out hand calculations of artillery trajectories for the army, ballistic trajectories for the navy, pursuit problems for the navy, rooms full of women with hand calculators calculating complicated trajectories. And in this case, of course, the differential equation that she's solving has to do with the positions and velocities, and there's an X position of the satellite, of the rocket, and a Y position and a Z position, and there's an X prime, Y prime, Z prime, and Newton's laws give you the forces of gravity that apply, and you just have to apply Euler's method 50,000 times. And because you want a short time step, because the longer time step saves you time, but you could very well, with a bigger time step, end up doing that which you really don't want to do. So you need a short time step to stay accurate, but that means you have a lot of time steps. And so the problem was, these are massive computations. We have rooms full of women carrying them out, but it takes a long time. And then, and this is historically accurate, there's a scene in the movie Hidden Figures where they wheel in this big computer, and the Octavia Spencer character looks at the computer, and they tell her what it's for. And she goes back to her room full of women, and she says, "Ladies, we are either computer programmers or we are unemployed." And she goes, you remember, she steals a book on computing from the library because they wouldn't lend it to her because she's African American. She got that book on computing languages, and they learned computing, and these things, calculations, started to be done with these giant new IBM computers. But as a tiny little footnote, there's a scene in the movie, which is, I checked, it's historically accurate, where John Glenn, the great John Glenn, is going up into an orbital flight, and they tell him that they computed his trajectories with these new computers, and he was accustomed to working with Katherine Johnson and trusted her, and John Glenn says to the head of the program at Houston, he said, "Did the girl check the calculations? I'm not flying unless she checked the calculations." And they asked her to do it, and she did some steps by hand to test the method, and she verified that it was doing it correctly. And Glenn said, "Okay, I will fly."